हेलो गाइस, दिस इज सत्या। माय रोल नंबर इज 19EC01023। टुडे आई विल बी शोइंग द प्लॉट्स ऑफ सम एलिमेंट्री फंक्शंस, पीरियोडिक वेव फॉर्म्स एंड एडिशनल मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ साइनोसॉइडल वेव्स एंड फाइनली इंटरैक्टिव जीयूआई व्हिच विल प्लॉट दिस ग्राफ्स। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट वी शुड रन दिस कमांड्स व्हिच विल क्लियर द वेरिएबल्स एंड क्लोज द फिगर विंडोज। कमिंग टू एलिमेंट्री फंक्शंस, फर्स्ट वन इज यूनिट स्टेप फंक्शन। Unit step function is a function where negative values will have 0 and for positive values the value is 1. We plot this by a Boolean expression t greater than or equal to 0, and this is continuous unit step function. This is discrete unit step function. We use the plot function and stem function to plot these graphs. And next one is rectangular signal, where from a limits in a limit it will have the value 1 and remaining will be 0. To produce this function I use these expressions, which will for some values it will have 1 and remaining values it will be 0, and this is continuous rectangular signal and this is discrete rectangular signal. And for discrete signals I use the sampling rate as 1. And the next one is signum function, for which for positive values the value will be 1 and for negative values the value will be minus 1, and for 0 it will be 0. So here you can see that for positive values it is 1 and negative values it minus 1. This is continuous and this is discrete signum function. And for ramp signal, for positive values the graph will be y is equal to x, and for negative values all the values will be 0. For this I used both Boolean expression which multiplied with itself with t, which will produce y is equal to x in for positive values. And the next function is complex exponential function. For complex exponential function we have two values, real value and imaginary value. So I plotted a 3D plot using plot3 function and stem3 function, which will plot 3D graph. This is helical in shape, and for this we used exp function, which will plot exponential function, and I is the imaginary value. And real valued exponential function is the next one. For this also we use the exp function. We have these two are continuous, and this is decaying function, this is rising function, vice versa. This is for discrete functions. For sinusoidal function we use the sine function, which will plot the sine graph. This is the sine graph and this is the discrete sine graph. And to plot causal exponential function, we use the same exponential function but multiplied with a Boolean expression. Causal exponential function has 0 for negative values and exponential for positive values. This is continuous and this is discrete. And finally, this is impulse function. This is just a Boolean expression. For 0 it will be 1, and for remaining values it will be 0. This is continuous and this is discrete functions. These elementary functions are used in communication. And coming to periodic functions, first one is sawtooth waveform. Sawtooth waveform looks like this. For certain value the graph increases, and suddenly it decreases to some value. I use this function to plot this. And FP is fundamental period of this graph. As these are periodic graphs, I used fundamental period for the functions. This is continuous and this is discrete sawtooth waveform. The next one is pulse waveform. Pulse waveform, the value will be 1 for some values, and this is a periodic function. You can see for this the period is pi and pulse width is pi by 4 as per the question. And the next one is square waveform. You can see that above 0 it looks like a square, and below also it looks like a square. And this is used for binary communication. For this I use it for loop, which will return positive values for some values and negative values for remaining values. The next one is triangular waveform. To produce a triangular waveform I used mod function, which returns remainder. To plot triangular waveform, I used mod function and some other expressions which will plot this triangular waveform. This is the expression I used which will have some functions for certain values and another function for other values, and the final result will be this. This is a triangular waveform. The final one is sinusoidal waveform. For this, the frequency is 1 millisecond, which have very small frequency, so I used very small increments. And this is the sinusoidal waveform, and FP is the fundamental period. And coming to addition of sinusoidal waveforms, the X1, X2, X3 are sine waves which have different frequencies and different amplitudes. When we add, the resultant graph will look like this. This has a period 0.2, but we can observe this from graph. And this is multiplication of two sine waves. X1, X2 are two sine waves with different frequency and different amplitude. Multiplication of the waves is used for modulation, where we can send high frequency waves through low frequency. As you can see, this is the resultant multiplication of sine two waves. And coming to GUI, I used App Designer. We can also use Guide. This is the GUI, and I used these components. This is buttons, and this is drop down, and we can, this is I made it interactive with this code. You can see, and when the plot button is clicked, it will run this code. In this function, I used switch statement, which will plot different graphs for different for different inputs. And in this each case, I used if else if statements, which will plot a continuous graph for some value for some input and other graph for other input. And this is the and these are some added functions to make the GUI interactive. So when we run the code, this is the app, which will take some time. And this is the app. First, we should select an option, and it will have a drop down. These are elementary signals. And let me select a signal, a RAM signal, and when we plot, and this is the RAM signal. I used some default T value limits. We can also change this, and when we click this button, it will show the grids. We can also change the axis. I use a drop down, which will change the axis properties. We can extend the T value limits for different values. You can see this. We can also change the increment. And coming to other function, complex exponential function, if you plot, it will plot a 3D graph. This is a 3D graph. We can also plot discrete graph for this. I use its default sampling period, 1 second. We can also change this to some 0.5, which will plot some more sampling rate this has. Like this, we can use, for example, causal exponential. This is the causal exponential, you can see. And coming to periodic graphs, we have sawtooth waveform and these waveforms. As periodic functions has fundamental period, I use it, this induces this input to put some fundamental period. And when we plot this, this is default fundamental period. You can see this is a sawtooth waveform. And for this, this is discrete. Do some, for example, pulse. This is pulse waveform. This is a square waveform. We can also change the period. For example, let 2 be the fundamental period. It will change the fundamental period. So this is discrete. So this is the GUI. Thank you.